Hey, welcome to our house. This is the most requested video of all time, and I'm finally gonna give you a tour of my house. Now, there's a lot of history in this house, 30 years of history, so this is gonna be a long video. First, I'm gonna take you on a tour of the whole house, showing all of the locations where I've filmed over the years, and then I'm gonna talk about the history of the house. And then I'm going to talk about the financial implications of buying versus renting. Now, I started making fitness videos in 2004, and that was before I was on YouTube. And this is the location right here. If you look at my first videos, the ones that have hundreds of millions of views, they were filmed right here. The fountain wasn't there at the time, there was something else there, but you'll recognize the tile. I did an ab video there. I did some push-up videos there, but this is where most of my videos were filmed. Now, in different versions, you can see those palms will be of different heights. The ferns will be in different states. And early on, there was not the creeping fig on the fence there. But this is where Scooby 1961 was born, right here on this patio. This is where the first videos were filmed, and probably half my videos were filmed here. This is my favorite location because it's on a covered patio, so it was a little sheltered from the noise. This is actually a dense suburban environment with a fair amount of noise, especially jets landing at SFO. So the patio cover helped block that noise. So I'm gonna take you on a tour here. I'm gonna start with the filming locations of my most famous videos. So we're gonna go inside here first, quick tour. This is a kitchen where all my cooking videos were filmed. This is the new kitchen, it's been remodeled. But right here on the floor, this is where my most famous video of all time was filmed. This is where I filmed the video. It was like a super set for Chest. I can't remember exactly where I was. I think I was right here. And the super set was, what was it? Flies, then push-ups, and then dumbbell press, all right here. And that's where this was filmed. You probably see the fireplace in that. Okay, so while we're here, this is the family room. I never showed the dining room. There were certain areas of the house that I never showed, but I'm getting a little ahead of myself. Let's do the yard tour first. So one thing you probably didn't realize, so this is where all my videos were filmed. This is the garage behind me here. This is where Dottie was built. I'll show you that later. Okay, oops. So this is cool. So by the way, I built all this. I laid this tile, I poured this concrete. I love this little walkway. I mean, this is so lush. We love our ferns. Here's our dolphin fountain. Now, I don't think I filmed any videos on this patio. I seriously doubt it. So you see, this is just a lush paradise. Our bamboo trees here. Now, I did film a number of videos here in front of the shed. You'll probably recognize this. In the videos I filmed here, there was a dolphin fountain. I did a lot of videos just seated right here in front of the fountain. Let's see. Now, This room right here, you're gonna recognize in a minute, that is where probably the other half of my videos were filmed. So let's go on an inside, actually, you know, let's let you look at this again, because we just love this yard. These ferns just grew naturally. We planted like one and they took over. Okay, so this goes to the front yard. I'm not gonna show you the front yard, but this is creeping fig on the fence. Okay, now I filmed, as you know, I filmed a lot of cooking videos here in the kitchen. And this, so I filmed many videos here. I filmed workout videos here, but also all the videos I did of building Dottie. This is where Dottie was built. It took me 20 years to build Dottie in this garage. And then later I did fitness videos here. Actually, you'll probably recognize this corner here. I had my TRX up here and I would do my TRX. There was a workbench right here. By the way, I keep talking about this in past tense and we will discuss that in a bit, but let's continue the tour first. Okay. So this is, again, the dining room was here, family room. Now, this was Scott's study. So I never filmed in here. And Scott's study is right off the patio, so he could watch me filming videos. So this is the hallway. Now, this is a room, this was my study for decades, and this is where most, the other half of my videos were filmed. If you remember, over here in this corner, I had the rack with all the plates on it, and most of my workouts were done on the carpet here, and over on this wall, I had my big TV that I use for a monitor. So that video I did about how to be more productive was filmed right there. I kept all my weights in this closet here. And here's another room you never saw. So this is the bathroom. Nobody ever shows their bathroom. And you can see out to the backyard. And another room you never saw, this was our master bedroom. As you see, it's just an amazing place. You get to see the ferns all around. And this is the master bath with the amazing shower. So that's kind of the tour, but wait, that's not it. This is the secret room. This is a great time for a commercial break. What's upstairs? These are Amsterdam style stairs, very steep. And look at this. This is the secret room. Pretty cool, huh? So this was, a lot of this was put in to support the solar panels. We'll be talking about the construction later, but let's go back out to the patio. So that, I think I pretty much gave you a tour of all the filming locations. Now, you know what's funny? It's like, I have to walk down like this because my feet are so big. There's no other way to fit them on those stairs. That's not a legal staircase, but it doesn't have to be because that's not a living space. Let's see. Now let's talk about the history of this house. As I said, there's a lot of history here. Let me plug in my Hold on a sec. So as I said, there's a lot of history here. Scooby's workshop, Scooby 1961, was born right here in 2004 when I started filming with the 640 pixel by 480 pixel digital camera without sound, because they didn't make them with sound back then. Anyway, so we purchased this house in 1989. That was 32 years ago. It was a 2-bedroom, 1-bath, which was fine, but it was not big enough. So I did the most of the physical work, but one wall was left standing. Everything else moved or was destroyed and rebuilt to make a 3-bedroom, 2-bath. So while I was holding a regular 9-to-5 job, on weekends and evenings, I would build the house. And we lived here while I was doing it. And it took 5 years of working after hours and weekends to turn it from a 2-bedroom, 1 into a 3-bedroom, 2. Now, it was a challenge. Living in a house while you're building it is never the easiest thing to do. As a matter of fact, there was one summer where there was a tent set up here to live in. There was a hose hanging over, connected to the laundry sink in the garage, so that we put a sprinkler on the top, and that was our shower, was a hose coming out of a laundry sink. So this was where we lived for a summer. Here on this patio. And that was before the patio cover was on. There was no patio cover back then. So let me show you the one wall that was standing. Let me show you what was expended. So what did not change, so this garage is 1949 original. That's when the house was built. You can see the framing construction. Cool, you can see the old knob and tube wiring up there. That's the way they used to wire. So this room was not touched, except for this wall that you can see I redid. This is not 1949 material. So everything moved. This wall in the kitchen moved by a foot. It moved a foot this way, made the kitchen smaller to make room for the bedroom. So this is the one wall in the house that we did not move, because there's a masonry fireplace in it and you can't move the fireplace. That's too much work. So this is the one wall that did not move. This room here was not here. The old floor line, this used to be the wall of the house here. So this little bit was added for a dining room. This wall was not here. This used to be a dining room and it was closed off and turned into a bedroom. As I say, everything moved, everything. This bathroom was not here. This room, there was 6 feet added on that room to make this a spacious master. This was not here. So there was a whole lot of work. That's why it took 5 years. And the way it would work, we would get one room habitable, move into that, and then work on the others. It's really inefficient, but if you want to live there, it's a way to save money. You don't have to pay rent for 5 years and a mortgage, which nobody can afford to do these days. Now, This was probably so you can see. This is the old 1949. Oh, you can't really see that well. Hold on, too much glare. So this is interesting. So you can see this is the old 1949 roof here, and you can see this used to be a peak. And then all this is new because of the added square footage down there. This roof had to be added. So the ridge line of the roof used to be here, and now it's right here. A lot of hemming and hawing and construction to get that to happen. Okay, I'm gonna go sit down and we're gonna talk about what's going on. So again, just wanted to give you this one final tour. So this is my study where most of the filming took place, about half the filming. Anything indoors was almost always here, my workout videos in this room. Oh, by the way, this is where the fish tank used to be. It's only recently that we put shelves here. So this is where the fish tank was, that everyone was always so concerned I would smash my dumbbells into. There was no concern because it was a plexiglass tank. Again, back out to the patio. So let's talk about what's happening. So we're actually selling this house. We, about a year ago, we bought a winter place down south where it's much warmer. And we were planning on keeping this house for a summer place. But as it turns out, you know what, we're just happier down there. And there was no reason to keep this house. So we're selling it. I wanted to talk to you a bit about the economics of renting versus buying. Now, people, when you talk to people about this, it's like they come up with all kinds of excuses about not buying. It's like, you know, well, if you buy, you have to do all the repairs yourself. I want someone else to do that. Or, you know, it's too expensive to buy. You know what? Housing is expensive, and every year it gets more expensive. It never gets cheaper. If you can afford to buy, buy now. The smallest thing you can afford, get your foot in the door. Let me give you an example of what has happened in this neighborhood. Our best friend Helen, three doors down that way, she died about 6 years ago on 4th of July. She was a secretary. Her husband was a social worker. In today's terms, that's like lower middle class or lower class. They were able to buy, easily afford in this neighborhood. And that was in 1961. So 61, 71, 81. 30 years later, my husband and I bought it here. We could barely afford it with two engineers' salaries. So within 30 years, it went from a secretary could buy here to two engineers could barely afford to buy here. Fast forward again, 30 years, we have owned this 30 years. Now there is not any way two engineers can afford to buy in this neighborhood. Now it's two C-level executives, CEO, COO, CFO. That's the kind of salary it takes to buy in this neighborhood. It's never getting cheaper. It always becomes more and more unaffordable. And that's why I say, you know what? Get your foot in the door now. A lot of people say, you know, well, I have access to subsidized housing or low-cost housing. I'm gonna rent, and then the money I would have spent buying the house, I'm gonna put that into the stock market. You know what happens? 99% of the time, they don't save that money. And what do they end up with? A bunch of direct-to-landfill crap from Walmart that gets thrown out. And then at the end of the 30 years, instead of owning a house free and clear, they have nothing. They have a bunch of crap in landfill. So this house, as I said, back in 1989, we bought it. Two engineers could barely afford it. 30 years later, I'm not going to tell you how much we sold it for, but what I will tell you is the cash we got from this, after taxes, we could afford to go on round the world cruises, the kind where you stay on the boat 365 days a year. We could do that for 15 to 20 years, the both of us. So when you're looking at renting versus buying, you gotta be careful in doing your spreadsheet to see if it's worthwhile. You gotta take the whole picture into account. One of the best things about a house is it's a forced savings plan, because few people have the financial discipline to actually save money if they're in cheap housing. It does not end up on the stock market or in investments, or either that or they blow it on crypto. So please consider that. I firmly believe that real estate is one of the few good investments left, and one of the safest. You know what? People say, well, what about the crash of, you know, when prices plummeted from coronavirus, or the SNL loan problems of 2005, I think it was. Even with, I lived through both of those. Even with that, the 1989 to 2021 gains are easily over tenfold increase in value. And remember, the house price went up tenfold. The down payment on the house was 10%. So if you look, that's actually the investment. The 10% down on the house. After that, our payments were not that much more than it would have been for rent after about the first 5 years. So when you look at the return on investment, it's astronomical. I want to give you another example. My parents, the house I grew up in, they bought it in 1972 for about $29,000, just, you know, a tract house. They sold it in 2015 for $900,000. That's a 30-fold increase, because the 70s had incredible inflation. And in my opinion, we are in for a crazy inflationary period like we had in the 1970s. So if you're waiting to get in the housing market thinking that prices are going to crash, you know what? Best of luck to you, because I don't think it's going to happen. I think housing is going to just become more and more unaffordable. Anyway, I didn't mean for that to turn into such a sales pitch for real estate, but it is pretty phenomenal. I wanted to give you a tour of the house, which I've done. So that's it for today. Thanks for watching. Al Peters Haynes.